So this is going to be our Libra Sun, Libra Moon, and as well Libra Rising, monthly, excuse me, general tarot reading, April 2020. And in case any of you guys is interested in a personal reading with me, checking out the description down below is gonna give you a link to my website from which you can purchase such. And another thing is that if you like the way I read tarot and you want to learn reading that way, you can sign up for my classes. To do so, you gotta go to my Facebook page, which is listed down below into the description again, and just give me an inquiry there on the Facebook page messages. So that being said, moving to the Libra general reading for the month. Now, the first card, which represents the very topic of the month for you, Libra, is going to be the Fool card, followed by the next one, which represents the energies which are feeding and supporting the topic here. And we have an amazing month for you guys. These two cards are really making, you're gonna see, but it's making the month so much worth everybody's while. I mean, in this case, your while, but I want to see those cards every time for Scorpio. And in a minute, you're gonna see why. So the next one, it is the challenges that you need to overcome throughout the months of April, and that will be the Ten of Swords, followed by the gifts and the blessings that you can enjoy throughout the month here. That will be the Page of Swords here, followed by the impression that you are leaving into the people around. We have the Five of Pentacles. Afterwards, the card shows what you can do in order to further your goal. I mean, long-term goal, which generally for everybody, or at least for the most people, it's how to be successful career-wise and how to be happy in love. That will be the High Priestess, followed by the next one, which represents what is gonna hurt your long-term career or relationship goal. That will be the Nine of Cups. And the last one, it is the guidance that Tarot is offering to you, Libra. We have the Three of Swords. So those eight cards. And now, why these two cards are making every month worth everybody's while? Well, simply put, those cards are pointing that whatever you have struggled for, whatever you tried to do, it's gonna happen throughout the month of April. I mean, you try to get a certain position in job. Well, that's happening into the month of April. You try to be with someone. That's happening into the month of April. Because the energies point that you were systematic, consistent, and as well meticulous enough to manifest a certain thing you tried to manifest to, and now that thing, it's basically materializing here through the month of April, giving you the new beginning you wanted. Now, important thing to be acknowledged though, it is that if you think that you do have an idea of everything that it is to happen in this new beginning of yours, you have no clue. I mean, you are yet to learn how to tackle with certain issues career-wise that are relating to your new position, to your new project, you know, to your new assignment, and so on and so forth. Or you are yet to kind of like synchronize with the new suitor of yours, with the new boyfriend or a girlfriend of yours, with the new situation that accompanies engagement or a marriage, and etc. etc. Now, the point here with those cards, it is that you have successfully accomplished the first stage of a very long-term unfoldment of things, either career-wise or either relationship-wise. And now, because that stage is over, the new stage starts in. And whatever you fought for, it's going to be simply given to you. Okay, so you fought for, once again, a new job. New job is what you're gonna get. You fought for a new relationship. New relationship, it is what you're gonna get. Why? Because you show to the universe that you deserve it and that you really want it. I mean, it's not like a kind of like a desire of yours. I don't know how to say it. Well, when a spoiled person just wants something for the heck of it, you are going to show that that's not the case with you, okay? That you really want it. I mean, you are sincere with the thing that you do want your next love, or that you do want improvement into your relationship, or that you do want a new job or improvement into your current job. It's going to be different for every single one of you guys, but whatever beginning you strive for, it's happening here into the month of April. Again, for some could be a relationship that they wanted to start. For others, it's going to be a job. If I had to count me in, and I was Libra, it would have been my tarot courses that are starting, okay? And something that I fought for a quite a long time. Those who are following me, they know that I am talking about them for like a good 3 years, and I was constantly hesitant to do it. You know, I tried it with people live in the sense of that face to face, it worked out. Then we tried it online, it worked out as well. And now I'm bringing it online for everybody, not just for a selected few. So it's a good thing that you can expect happening here into the month of April. Now, one advice I want to give you, Libra, don't try to be, the word is not serious, but let's say don't panic if you see that it is way too much to handle, at least at the start. So you get reassigned into a job that you're so excited to do, and you start performing in there the very first couple of days at the new place that you're working. You see how much, how demanding it is, okay, and how much you gotta do, and so you panic. Am I gonna be able to do it? Yes, you will. It's just you have to calm yourself down, okay, and just try to play with the game. It's because the Fool kind of predisposed for a creative chaos. You definitely are not gonna know everything that you gotta do, or you are not gonna be in tune, not in tune, but kind of like with a profound understanding of everything you gotta do, but you're gonna get the hang of it, you know, very, very quickly, only if you do not panic though. Now, next one, it will be in term of the challenges that you will have to overcome in that, in such an environment. So the challenges are about a kind of like swift actions, in a sense of that you have to be very acute with your decision making, and as well with the actions that you gotta take. Now, with the Ten of Swords also predisposed for a certain sacrifice. So you fought for something, you can have it, but you have to give up on something else that you already have, okay? So not for everybody is going to be just a clean cut where it is just only an addendum. You add to your current endeavors, but you maybe have to sacrifice one endeavor for the favor of this a new beginning. And that is especially true for a relationships. You know, you have to sacrifice your singularity in favor of being being in a couple, in a couple's type of, you know, interactions. Or if you are in a dysfunctional relationship, you have to sacrifice that dysfunctional one for a new one. Again, that sacrifice doesn't have to be hard to make, but it's irreversible. That's the point of the Ten of Swords. Once you do it, there is no going back. And for some of you, it could be an equilibrium here, okay? You have to sacrifice one job for another while you like both of those jobs. You know, it's gonna be a tough decision, I'm saying, for some of you. And it's a challenge that you need to overcome. You need to make up your mind, because otherwise with the Ten of Swords, you lose both, okay? You just gotta be definitive whenever you have to decide something. And once again, there won't be any coming back from it. So you need to be well aware what you want for your future, which is the energies of the reading here with the Knight of Pentacles, and decide in favor of that future that you do want, instead of being hesitant about it, okay? So once again, you are with someone, but it's not like the person you want to be with, all right? And your ideal one appears into the month of April, and you are hesitant deciding, should I jump into it? Well, that's a bad thing. You have to be very decisive in regards to what you want into the month of April, and jump without putting much thought into it, in it here, which is with the Ten of Swords going to provoke a new era in your life in general into the month of April, and not just into the month of April, but also moving forward into the future. Next one, it is the gifts and the blessings that you get to enjoy throughout the month. And I don't know if that's going to be a gift and blessing, really. That is a person who is harping you around. Someone that says, I mean, you're going to let this thing go away? I mean, are you crazy, you know, or are you a fool? to allow that job to slip away or to miss that person around that is really into you and you want to date, that's someone who tells you the cold truth straight away, right into the face, without kind of like sparing you or anything. I mean, that one ain't going to be milder, guys. It's going to call you names as well. It's going to be brutal with the words. There won't be any, how do you say it in English? Any tactical explanations. You know, under tactical explanations, I mean when you try to explain something without insulting the person around. Well, this one is going to be pretty brutal and pretty rude as well. But that is so you really listen to what they have to say and really make a note of what kind of a thing you are in a danger of missing if you do not make up your mind. Once again, it all comes to making up your mind, okay? And another thing about the Page of Swords, it is if you do need help with something and the help is coming up, is coming from nowhere, that card points that you are going to be gifted with an unexpected source of help. That could be an unexpected person which is going to help you, unexpected fundings, for example, or unexpected, once again, a means that you can use to help improve in your current situation. Next one, it will be what kind of impression you're going to leave into the people around. That is the impression of the Five of Pentacles. And kind of like people are going to commiserate on you. What I mean it is that they will kind of see what kind of a rough situation you are in a sense of deciding, okay? Like my point is that they're not going to give you a hard time, but rather they will try to help you with whatever they can. Empathizing to you, trying to give you an advice, trying to help you with whatever they can, and etc. etc. It's pretty much, this isn't a pity out of because they kind of like see you in a disadvantageous position. Just on the contrary, that is a pity in a favor of they want to see you in an advantageous position in a sense of that people does not want to see you missing a good opportunity in your life. So with this card, I safely can say, Libra, that everybody around you, at least in the month of April, will will think the best for you and will try to help you achieve the best for yourself, even if they are once again a bit rough and harsh with their words and with their guidance, and even if they are criticizing you more than cheering you around. Next one, it is what you can do to further your goal here. And we do have the High Priestess. That is very important, especially for those who are looking for love, guys. That card points that if you do not find that the love you have is a true love, then this is the thing you have to sacrifice, definitely, because the High Priestess is about soulmating, it's about twin flaming, it's about the true love. This is about fulfilling the needs of your soul, okay? And that is exactly what you need to do. And I'm sorry that I have to say it, but once again, I need to give you the example of the relationship you are in, just because you don't want to be alone, and suddenly a person comes around that is everything you ever wanted, and you are hesitant leaving this one that you are in, that you are with right now, because you feel pity for them, missing the one that actually is going to fulfill the needs of your soul. So you have to be very, very decisive here. And in terms of career, that card points that you gotta stay exactly where you are, okay? That will help you further your goal, because this is where the new beginning is gonna start from, okay? Or not exactly where you are, but you need to keep up with the idea you have. For example, if you want a new job, that is the idea you need to keep up with, instead of changing constantly your mind. That is what the High Priestess is all about. And the other card that we do have, it is what you can do to hurt your goal here. We have the Nine of Cups. And in this particular narrative, the Nine of Cups points to doing nothing, in a sense of that you kind of like try to convince yourself that what you are, what where you are right now, it is everything you have ever wanted. Therefore, do not allowing the new beginning to unfold. That it is the topic of your month here, with the Fool card, the new love to unfold, the new job to unfold, the new project to unfold, you know, the new position to unfold, and etc., etc. So very important to seize the initiative as soon as the opening appears in front of you to manifest whatever you have worked for in the recent past. And the last one, it will be in term of guidance. That is Three of Swords. Pretty easy one. It relates to the gifts and blessings and as well to the impression of others. Like said, you are to be criticized. Why you are not seizing the opportunity? Why you are not grasping? Why you are pulling yourself so much away from it? And you gotta listen to that criticism. This is the guidance of the Three of Swords. Yes, you are going to be so-called victim of a mental cruelty, meaning once again the people were, that person, Page of Swords especially, is gonna call you names, is gonna tell you that you are stupid, that you are a fool, and etc. etc. And actually that is exactly the thing that you need to listen to. I mean, that it will be foolish from your behalf to miss the new opportunity just because you're not feeling comfortable of sacrificing one thing over this new prospect that you are going to stand against. So decisions, and as well some courage, it's needed here throughout the month of April, guys. But definitely Libra, new heights are in front of you, and I hope that the sense of what you want is going to overcome the sense of fear of leaving something behind. So yeah, that being said, this was your monthly tarot reading, general tarot reading, April 2020. Hopefully you enjoyed it and you liked it. And if you are interested in a personal reading with me, checking out the description down below is going to give you a link to my website from which you can purchase such. And as well, if you like the way I read tarot cards, guys, you can sign up for my classes, if you will, to learn how to read the same way. In order to do so, go to my Facebook page, it is listed here into the description down below, and give me an inquiry into the Facebook page messages. So stay safe now, and hopefully we're going to see each other around. Until then, bye.